Welcome back to FP Executive. We're here today with Jacoline Loewen, author of Money Magnet. The second part of our discussion, we're talking about companies with revenue in excess of $10 million who are looking for money to help grow their business and to access that private money world that is out there. And this is a world that you know a lot about.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't realize there was all this money out there. Tell me a little bit about, you know, where this money is coming from and
there's $1 trillion of that money in dry powder looking
wow.
to get placed.
Hmm.
And you know, Obama was asking people to go and get loans from the banks and say to the banks, please, would you lend more banks?
Right.
No. That was not the right message. What the message he should be saying is, entrepreneurs, we're in a new world now.
Mm-hmm.
You were in an aquarium about this big,
right.
which is your country, right? And so you had a couple of big fish. Those are the stock market. About 10%
mm-hmm.
of our businesses are on the stock market.
Mm-hmm.
80 to 90% are privately held companies,
mm-hmm.
family businesses.
Right.
So now that aquarium has been put into the ocean.
Oh, okay.
And whether you like it or not, there's big fish coming in from China, India,
mm-hmm.
all around the world.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have to compete, all you little fish. And it is going to change our whole world of business. We have to change.
Now,
and
how does someone access this private money?
Well, you could just go on to, there's a website called, our website, Loewen & Partners,
mm-hmm.
loewenpartners.com.
Okay.
And come on our website. We help people access, like if you have 10 million revenues plus,
mm-hmm.
we will guide you to the right fit of private equity for you.
Now, the right fit, you say that with a certain emphasis. So clearly
yeah.
the fit's important here.
Well, the thing to really understand is that private equity, only the top 25% of private equity funds are the really, really, really high performers.
Okay.
The rest aren't that great.
I see.
So they're going to sit on your board. Remember I was talking about if they're going to work for their money?
Yes.
Sweat equity, it's called. A lot of them don't.
Okay.
A lot of them are former bankers, and
mm-hmm.
they're going to treat your company like an ATM machine.
Oh, dear.
And I
mm-hmm.
see it as it's not just an opportunity for private equity to invest in your company. It's a privilege. A lot
okay.
of these family businesses have been around. We have a company called Birmingham,
mm-hmm.
fourth generation family business. It's been in Hamilton 150 years.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And so to put private equity in there,
mm-hmm.
you have to understand a lot of these entrepreneurs, they're not looking to grow.
Okay.
They've got a nice lifestyle that's happening.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden, bang, competition arrives from Germany,
mm-hmm.
from Spain, from China, from India, from Brazil,
mm-hmm.
And it's extremely upsetting because it's too late by the time they arrive
right.
for you to compete.
Mm.
So better, as in Birmingham's case, they got private equity and they got 10 million and they have now taken their company out to the world stage.
Okay.
So here we are in a recession, right? Everyone
mm-hmm.
else is depressed. What are
yes.
they doing? They're out doing acquisitions down in the States.
Uh-huh.
We were helping them do that.
Mm-hmm.
They're going over to Amsterdam this week to go do acquisitions over there. They're in construction. They do manufacturing.
Mm-hmm.
And in this province, we're being told, oh no, stop with the manufacturing. We're lost. It's a finished business. It is not at all.
So you see a prosperous future for manufacturing as long as people understand how to access the private money out there and to get the right fit.
Yes.
Hmm.
And to get money that's going to help them go global because the Canadian brand is brilliant and Canadians don't realize that.
All right.
I think part of it is we are sitting next to the US, the number one economy in the world.
Okay.
It's going to carry on being a cash
mm-hmm.
cow for the
mm-hmm.
next 20 years.
Right.
People are panicking because they're thinking, oh, we've all got to go to China.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, you don't have to panic. We're the ninth largest economy in the world.
Mm-hmm.
But what's happening is Canada is a very exciting place for people who don't live in Canada.
Okay.
Americans are realizing that if they take a Canadian brand to the world, it's a
mm-hmm.
far more attractive business than
really
if they take an American brand. Like Canadian companies are very attractive
mm-hmm.
in the rest of the world.
Now, why is this? Is because from your experience, Canadians are seen as more honest, forthright. What's the sell? What's the value proposition on the Canadian brand?
Canadians are smart.
Okay.
Look at RIM.
Yes.
You know, I think we've got this cold weather, so we can go inside and do a lot of research.
Lots of time to think, yes.
But actually, number one,
mm-hmm.
ethical.
Oh, okay.
Ethical. Really, frankly, business should all be done on a handshake
yes.
anyway. I mean,
mm-hmm.
the lawyers will hate me for saying that, but you do need the lawyers, obviously. But,
yes.
Businesses, it's ethics. And,
mm-hmm.
I mean, I think for the Americans, I'm hearing a lot of American companies looking for Canadian companies to take then to the world right. as their brand and their company.
That's great to hear that that kind of positioning is out there and that Canadians are well, not just perceived, but are in fact do business in that sort of way. If we can go back to the fit a little bit. So mm-hmm. you find a private equity partner who's willing to participate in the management or strategic direction of the business. Mm. Can owners have a bit of trouble sort of dealing with that kind of input at times, though?
I mean, of course they are going to have problems.
There's challenges there, is there not?
Of course, and that's the excitement of it all. And right. if you have, I mean, what we do with, say, for Birmingham, for example,
right.
we understand the personalities.
Yes.
We understand how is it going to look over the next 5 years. So first mm-hmm. of all, you have a five-year strategy plan.
Okay.
Because you're going to be having something happen in 5 years for the private equity people to leave the business.
Right, okay.
So let's discuss that. Mm-hmm. How's it going to look? Is it going to be a big strategic buyer? They've got this huge German competitor who could buy them. Mm-hmm. Is it going to be, they're in the construction infrastructure industry. Okay. How fabulous is that?
Yes.
Is it going to be a Chinese company? Are we going to be like the oil sands? They've got mm-hmm. so many options. Are they going to IPO? Will they okay. go public? It's mm-hmm. to get that cash back out and back mm-hmm. into the private equity's hands.
So it's really planning, sitting down and thinking through, sort of doing yes. decision trees, for example, in terms of if this happens, this is where we go and
oh,
so
yes.
forth.
Oh, yes. So and it's I just hired a CFO for Birmingham, and mm-hmm. part of that is the private equity guys get to say who's going to be that CFO. They get rights on that.
Right.
And it's in their contract.
So you do have to give up a little bit of control then as well when you're bringing in these new partners.
Oh, yes. And it's, you know, I mean, for the owners, their success has been because they have such strong egos.
Okay.
You have to have a strong ego. And it's mm-hmm. I love working with those guys because they are so energetic and exciting and mm-hmm. big thinking and creative. But you've heard about men are from Mars and women are from Venus.
Yes,
or was
yes.
it the other way around? And Mars for the men. I would say that private equity is from Mars. And
okay.
and probably the entrepreneurs are from Mercury.
Okay.
Because they're so energetic. It's all about the marketing and the product. Mm-hmm. While for the private equity guys, they're totally financially focused. It's a mm-hmm. totally different skill set.
Do you think they impose a bit of discipline as well on those entrepreneurs?
Of course. That's yes. why mm-hmm. there's research out of Harvard showing that companies that have gone through private equity first, mm-hmm. then IPO into the public market, are the ones that are far more successful. Because they've already had the discipline of having the quarterly meetings where you have to have certain information. And you know what happens is when that certain information has been asked for and they can't get it, mm-hmm. then there's pressure. Oh, okay, we now do need to know which one of our projects is the most profitable.
Right,
And for a company like Birmingham, for example, we were having problems with the finances. Just imagine you're doing two projects, one oranges,
right.
one apples. Mm-hmm. So they were mixing it up. So you were getting costs in from the apples going into the oranges. And then you were thinking, wow, this oranges project is very expensive. This apples project's really cheap. Let's do more apple projects.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
So if you don't have your numbers working for you, many companies have that.
So there is a world of private equity out there that we can discover. Perhaps I would encourage people to go to your website at Loewen and Partners to explore private equity a little bit more fully, and then also to perhaps pick up Money Magnet as well as another resource to look into private equity. Jacoline, thank you so much for joining us today at FP Executive.